This is the story of the romance of the mahogany tree. And how we place more value on the furniture made from this tree. But to truly honor the spirit of the tree, we must return to the wood at the time of its sacrifice. In the dignity of the woodcutter. After supper, the elder brother, Jonathan Dickerson, decided he should move to Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and act as a spokesman and salesman for the products of the Dickerson plantation. Jonathan made arrangements to load plantation products into the next ship that was sailing to Philadelphia. To correct the problem, his crew loaded some useless mahogany logs deep in the ship to keep the ship level during heavy storms. Jonathan then dropped by the shops of a few cabinet makers. It just took the call of free wood to seriously reduce the pile of mahogany logs.
Well, thank you.
Within a few months of his arrival, he was visited by several cabinet owners who said,
"I now prefer mahogany because it will not warp or crack."
Woodworkers then asked if they could receive a regular supply of Jamaican mahogany. And over time, the Jamaican plantation owners worked hard to meet the demand. In 1722, Jonathan Dickerson wrote his brother in Jamaica just before his death. be a sailor like my father and have an adventure. Next, I want to explore the jungle and fulfill my dreams to cut down the trees.
Yes, Mr. Card, I believe you would be satisfied.
So you're saying I should put all my trust in this guy, Gordon, and follow his advice?
Yes, we are.
The cell pores for the final finishing without opening the log. Then his crew cut around the tree and then built a platform above the buttress of the tree. That was followed by the felling of the tree itself. The tree would be trimmed and squared. Month of May, the dry season was ending, and the crew headed home for a 6-month break.
Rastafari.